And the exact number of turns depends on the height of the river.
Pete Lushmore's earliest memories, helping his grandfather work this since-retired West Country watermill. He never imagined he'd be required to restart production.
The local shops came back to us and said, yes, please, we would love some flour. There were no other shops around that were anywhere near us who had any sort of supply. I suppose there is a sort of feeling of pride, not personal pride, but to be able to be one of the people who keeps the old place going.
Water has powered a mill here for a millennium, but the mechanism was last fully operational in 1970. It became a museum, occasionally producing flour for tourists. But now it's back in business.
The UK's flour sector is at full capacity, producing 4 million bags worth of flour each week. And still there's a shortage, which is why this historic mill is coming in handy for this particular part of Dorset when it's most needed.
Imogen Bittner, Pete's assistant, has had to learn on the job. Usually a volunteer in the museum, now a vital part of the operation.
I grew up here, so I've always known the mill. I live just 300 metres down the road. So for me, it's especially nice to be back in there.
The Sturminster Newton Mill was operating during the 1918 flu pandemic and came through the plague. This piece of local history has been brought back to life. Its cogs have ground the grains of a ton of flour in 2 weeks. And it's now showing the way for other historic mills.
I've already had two other mills phone me and ask me exactly what I'm doing, because they are thinking of doing the same. Hopefully we'll have one or two more historic mills coming into a little bit more production.
The flour has helped local bakeries keep bread on the shelves. Pete, a custodian of the past, proving history has a place in the present. Luke Hanrahan, Euronews.